In this video, we're gonna work with EOMonth function in Excel to find the last job of the month. Hey guys, welcome to Excel tutorial channel, and in this video we're gonna cover EOMonth in this date and time functions playlist in Excel to find the last day of the month with some twists in this video. So you're gonna learn so much from this video. So if you haven't subscribed to this channel, please do it, because in the upcoming days we're gonna cover so much about the Excel. So let's get started. So here we have this particular project here, and we have the start date and months needed and this deadline. To get the date of the last day of the month in Excel, we usually use the EOMonth, which is actually abbreviation of end of month function. If we just apply here what is the end of month's argument, EOMonth's argument, here the start date and months to be added. So it will just give the last date, or you can say last date of the month. Like if you have a July is our current month here, and it will apply to the 31st of July, right? Like that. But if you have some start date like this, and you have something months needed towards the end of the that particular month, you can use this EOMonth. So if we just apply like this for the demonstration, and the months, I don't want to month add any months here, let it be a default here. It will say you have entered too few argument for this function, and to why, because we haven't entered the months here. And if you want until the current month, which is the July, then you can just add zero here, and it will default the value towards the current month's end date. So when we apply this and we have this date which is not formatted in the date format, and we just apply the format cell here, go to the date, and it will apply like this, and you got the 31st of July 2021, right? And if you apply to all, it will apply the same, because the all dates are in the July. But we have some conditions here which is specified here, months needed. And for the months needed part, we need to edit a formula with this cell, right? And it, let's see when we apply here. So it gives the next month, which is the 8th, which is the August of 31st, right? If we apply to all, and it gives the value of that particular month's ending, which is here we have 31st of December 2021, because we need 5 months from this scripting to end. So hope you get the point how we can use the EOMonth, which is the end of the month. But if you want something like in the negative aspect, you can also do that. But it is not related to this demonstration. Like we have this end of month and start date. If you want something like to backdate a data a bit, like let's say minus 10 here, you can also do that, and it just give the end date of last 10th month. So here we have September 30th, 2020. You can also do that with the negative value as well. So hope you get the point how to use the EOMonth here, which is very basic and straightforward for you. And this is very short video, because I just want to let you know this formula, because it can benefit your daily Excel life. If you get the point, please click the like button. If you want to know more about these functions, you can also subscribe to our channel. If you have something in mind or questions or something sort of like that, you can also ask in the description box. So see you in the next video. Until then, bye bye.